I promised in the edge-to-edge video that I would show you how to fix it when you set up an edge-to-edge with using trim and you get those diagonal lines in here. But I actually haven't been able to replicate those diagonal lines, even though this is the same computer that I used yesterday on the other video. But I think you know what I'm talking about. It's when you use the trim function. So what I do, if I do get those diagonal lines, is I actually delete the row that has the problem, and then I copy a new row. And put it in place, and then just use the trim function on your computer. I'll do it with the mouse, but normally you would do it with the head. And I've done a horizontal trim, and I will accept that, and it will get rid of those diagonals without you having to do a bunch of splitting and having a bunch of starts and stops. This video is to introduce you to the patterns that I designed that I refer to as trimmables. And I started designing them because it gave me some more flexibility on getting across the quilt and back without having to sort of travel with weird little loops or anything. I can do a lot of graphic things with these kind of patterns. And they're designed to be about 100 inches wide, so they would go across the width of a quilt. So I'm going to drag this pattern on. I call it Microbio Modern. And you can place it using the tools that we just talked about in the edge-to-edge options. I'm going to have it on multiply, and I'm going to say one across. It's not an edge-to-edge pattern. You can't put them side-by-side, but I can do multiples going down the quilt. So I'll say 8, just jump guessing, generate edge-to-edge, and then I can decrease my row gap to where I like it, and sort of grab them all, use the transform tool to get it placed on the quilt, and then I'm going to use some trim functions. But you can see this gives you a great texture of quilt without an identifiable repeated pattern. So it looks really complicated, but it's not. On this Microbio Modern pattern, when it stitches, you can see the start and the end are stacked here. So basically it stitches half of all these shapes and then comes back and completes the other half and ends here. So this one you can just set up by eyeball. But on some of the other ones, let's see, like this, my sandstorm pattern, I actually design it to where the start of one ends up at the end of the next. So if I copy one pattern and bring it down, the start and end would just overlap like that. So you can set it up by copying and pasting if you want. And that's how it's designed to interlock. Of course, you can adjust it however you want. You can move it around and get a whole different look to it if you want to. So these patterns are really flexible and offer some great options. Here's some other examples of those trimmable patterns that are kind of fun. So I call this one Laverne and Shirley because it kind of reminds me of the chenille embroidery that were on their skirts. And this one is Viney trimmable. And then these are some that I recently did for a customer who was doing a Batman quilt. So let's set these up. There's actually 3 different rows, and so you can kind of leave them hanging off the quilt. Let's do row 2, and you can move them around and pick what part that you want to show, sort of overlap them. Let's get this laid in here. So there's actually 3 different ones that have these fun terms that they have in the campy old Batman and Robin videos when I was a kid. So they were terrible actors, and in the fight scenes they would switch over to these words instead. So you can repeat that, copy and paste, to do another set of them down the quilt. So just another great option for you on setting up really creative quilts. Now when you're using these trimmables, to remove the extra pattern that extends off the edge of the quilt is really easy. You can use the trim tool up here. So let's pick that. I want to trim, and I'm going to do it with the mouse. Normally you would put the sew head on the edge of the quilt, but I'll demonstrate it with the mouse. And I want to do a vertical trim, and I'll go ahead and choose the entire quilt. And so if I click on the quilt with my mouse, or if I was using the head, I would be at the edge of the quilt and choose that. It turns it orange. And that's going to be the part that it removes. And so if it picks the wrong part, you can say invert. So I'll go ahead and say accept. And I can switch that to horizontal. Click up here with my mouse. And cancel that. Invert, remove the top, and work my way around the quilt that way. I tend to only do a couple rows as I work down the quilt, just in case there's some wonkiness in the quilt. If the quilt has irregular edges, there's another option for you. Let's say you get a quilt in that has a very irregular shape to it. This would be kind of extreme, but you get the point. And it could include just a really crazy, wonky border that a customer has where using the trim option with a straight line, even if you angle, it's not the best option. So here's how you can use a pushpin boundary and your mask tool to remove part of the quilting. So you could let it stitch off, but again, that's, you know, just taking time, and time is money when you have a machine quilting business. So let's go ahead and do another technique. So I have it, I would have clicked around the quilt using the sew head to create a boundary, and I would have made sure that it was closed and connected when I did it. So that's a closed shape that shows the bottom section of the quilt that we were getting ready to quilt. So the next step I'm going to do is click another boundary from the computer using the mouse, and I'm going to follow that along. I'll start out here to the side, and then I'll just click on those same points across the quilt. This very strange quilt that has a pointed bottom edge. And I go out a little bit beyond the quilt and come over here and then say done. And because I have it closed when done, it will close that shape. So now what I can do is touch the very edge of that shape and right click and unlock it. I want to unlock the pushpin boundary that I just created. And I picked it so it's red. So then I'm going to go to the mask tool, and I'm going to say build using that shape that I just unlocked, and it's going to turn purple. And so then you have to click it again, and it turns pink. And then the next step is I choose the pattern that I want to trim and click it so it's black, and come down here and say accept, and it will remove that quilting. You'll notice that there's another row. I could click that next and also say accept, and it would remove that as well. So now let me go ahead and get rid of that pushpin boundary. And this would stitch, I'll say remove all, just get rid of those. It would stitch and travel along the bottom of that quilt. So that would be how you would do a mask tool on an irregular edge to trim away excess pattern. So I hope you've learned some pointers out of this video. Again, we're totally happy to have some feedback from you. And if there's something that you'd like to see us do another video on, just let us know at jukeboxquilts.com.